The NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope has captured a spectacular image of NGC 3603, a giant nebula hosting one of the most prominent massive young clusters in the Milky Way. This is a splendid location for continuing our detailed studies of stellar birth in star-forming regions.
Welcome to the Hubblecast. Today we are going to travel to the heart of a massive cluster of young stars that lies deep inside a vast nebula of gas and dust. The nebula is called NGC 3603, and it is located about 20,000 light-years from Earth in the carina spiral arm of our own Milky Way galaxy. Now, turns out that the nebula is actually the nursery of the star cluster. It is thought that the nebula contains hundreds of thousands of solar masses worth of gas, and only about 1 million years ago, some of that gas collapsed in on itself and formed probably all of the stars in the cluster at more or less the same time in a massive burst of star formation. Today, we see the result as a glittering collection of stars surrounded by a dense cloud of hydrogen gas. In this new, detailed image from Hubble, we can see thousands of young blue stars sparkling against their maternal nebula. But this is not as tranquil a place as you might think. Some of the action is still going on. The strong ultraviolet radiation and the winds from these newborn stars are shaping and sculpting the surrounding gas, carving out a huge cavity into the nebula.
A team of astronomers was able to use the Hubble Space Telescope to peer into the heart of a star-forming region which was first observed in 1834 by Sir John Herschel, the son of the world-renowned astronomer Sir William Herschel. They were able to make detailed observations of stars whose masses differ, but whose ages are similar. Because of this fact, astronomers were able to study a wide range of stars at different points in their respective life cycles and make comparisons with other similar star clusters.
The new Hubble image is full of interesting objects for astronomers to study. Here, at the top right of the image, we see a handful of Bok globules. These objects were first observed in the 1940s by astronomer Bart Bok. They are some of the coldest objects in the universe, and they are dense clouds of gas and dust of around 10 to 50 solar masses, and they are collapsing to form new stars. Around the cluster, near the densest part of the nebula, we see these huge pillars of gas pointing away from the cluster's core. These were shaped by the massive young cluster stars, and eventually they will be dispersed into interstellar space. One of the most interesting objects in the image is this seemingly innocuous bright star. This star is designated SHER 25, and it is actually a blue supergiant nearing the very end of its life.
Astronomers think that in the not too distant future, SHER 25 will explode as a tremendous event like supernova 1987A, which has been observed by Hubble on many occasions. In doing so, it will seed space with the heavy elements necessary for planet formation. Perhaps it will even trigger a new wave of star formation in a nearby nebula. For now, though, astronomers using the Hubble are interested in the stars within the massive young cluster at the heart of NGC 3603. Several stars at the cluster's core have caused astronomers to be deceived. The huge stars in the innermost regions of the cluster appear to be far more massive than our current theoretical limits dictate. Nothing escapes the sharp eye of Hubble, though, as it was able to show that these stars are in fact the light from several stars blended together. They appear as one star, but are actually composed of two or even three components. This agrees well with previous observations of these apparently heavyweight objects, as composed of several stars of around 80 to 120 solar masses each.
The new Hubble image is full of amazing detail. Not only are we seeing a whole cluster of stars just 1 million years after its birth, But there's also one star that is about to go supernova in a gigantic explosion that will be seen across large parts of the galaxy. In NGC 3603, we are literally seeing the birth and death of stars right before our eyes. So this apparently picturesque stellar nursery is in fact the site of some pretty extreme astronomy.
New Hubble observations of the massive globular cluster, NGC 2808, provide evidence that it has three generations of stars, instead of one as current theories predict.
Globular clusters are the homesteaders of our Milky Way galaxy, because they were born during our galaxy's formation. They are compact swarms of typically hundreds of thousands of stars that are being held together by gravity. Now, astronomers have long thought that globular clusters experience a single baby boom of star formation at the beginning of their lives and then settle into a rather quiet existence. New observations by the NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope is showing that this idea may be too simple. The Hubble analysis of the massive globular cluster NGC 2808 is providing evidence that instead of having one baby boom of star formation, starbirth went boom, 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 creating three generations of stars early on in the cluster's life.
The astronomers used Hubble's advanced camera for surveys to measure the brightness, seen along this axis, and the color of the cluster stars, seen here, with blue to the left and red to the right. The measurements showed three distinct populations, with each successive generation appearing slightly bluer. This color difference suggests that successive generations contain a slightly different mix of some chemical elements.
Astronomers commonly believed that globular clusters produced only a single stellar generation, because the energy from that first batch of stars cleared out the remaining gas needed for more stars. But a hefty cluster like NGC 2808, which is 2 to 3 times more massive than typical globular clusters, may have enough gravity to hold on to that gas. Although the astronomers have searched only 2 globular clusters for multiple stellar generations, they say this may be a typical occurrence in other massive clusters as well. Now, no one is taking the radical step of suggesting that previous work on other clusters is no longer valid. But this discovery does show that the study of stellar populations in globular clusters may be heading in a new direction. The team plans to use ESA's Very Large Telescope in Chile to study the chemical composition of NGC 2808. This may offer further evidence that the stars were formed at different times, and it may yield clues as to how they formed. The team will also use Hubble to hunt for multiple generations in about 10 more hefty globular clusters.
For astronomers, Omega Centauri has been an outcast amongst globular clusters for a long time. A new result obtained by the NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope and the Gemini Observatory provides a surprising explanation for Omega Centauri's peculiarities.
Welcome to the Hubblecast. Today's cosmic guest star is a very special object. Omega Centauri has long been known to be the largest and brightest globular cluster visible in the night sky. Now, a globular cluster is a nearly spherical group of tens to hundreds of thousands of old stars, tightly bound together by gravity and found in the outskirts of many galaxies, including our own Milky Way. Beautiful but enigmatic, Omega Centauri has always been a bit of a puzzle to astronomers.
Omega Centauri lies in the constellation of Centaurus and is visible from Earth with the naked eye. It's one of the favorite celestial objects for Southern Hemisphere stargazers, appearing almost as large as the full moon when seen from a dark site. Exactly what type of object Omega Centauri is has long been a contentious topic. It was first listed in Ptolemy's catalogue as a single star nearly 2,000 years ago. In 1677, Edmund Halley reported it as a nebula. In the 1830s, the English astronomer John Herschel was the first to recognize it as a globular cluster, a classification that it has kept ever since.
Omega Centauri has several characteristics that separate it from other globular clusters. Compared to a run-of-the-mill globular, Omega Centauri has a highly flattened shape, it rotates faster, and it includes several generations of stars, which is an unusual feature for globulars, which normally contain only a single generation of old stars. Moreover, Omega Centauri is almost 10 times more massive than other globular clusters, almost as massive as a small galaxy. Now, new images obtained with the Advanced Camera for Surveys on board the NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope and data obtained with the GMOS spectrograph at the Gemini Observatory show that Omega Centauri appears to be harboring an elusive intermediate mass black hole at its center.
The black hole was discovered after astronomers measured the motions and brightnesses of stars at the center of Omega Centauri. They found that these stars were moving much faster than expected, given their total number and brightness. Such behavior clearly indicates the existence of something extraordinarily massive at the center of the cluster. The intense gravitational field of a black hole with a mass of 40,000 solar masses provides just the kick necessary to explain the measurements.
One implication of this discovery is that it is very likely that Omega Centauri is not a globular cluster at all, but rather some kind of dwarf galaxy that has been stripped of its outer stars and dark matter, as some scientists have suspected, for a few years. More than 2,000 years after Omega Centauri was wrongly classified as a star, its true nature is finally coming to light. But I wonder, does Omega Centauri have more surprises in store for us?